You know, my parents have always been massive supporters of me from the beginning. I mean, when I said I wanted to write songs at six, they kind of always believed in that dream with me. And so having my hometown be the same town I get to chase this dream in is a big deal, and I don't take that for granted. Especially when we travel so much, getting to come home and get a nice home-cooked meal and see my family when we're back. It's one of those things that always kind of brings you back down to earth.
I think you always did a really good job of encouraging from the start.
You bought my first guitar?
I did buy your first guitar. A little yellow guitar in a pawn shop in Pennsylvania. Because all you did was sit around on the porch and sing all the time.
The way you expressed that emotion and curiosity was through a song. Well, it's been a long-standing joke with your dad and I. We'll be like, what is going on? Like, either about a girl or about, like, whatever life circumstance. And we joke and go, oh, we'll have to wait on the song. I don't hate Alabama. I don't hate Alabama.
I was thinking about, like, getting more emotional about the Opry by the day. Like, all of my people that, like, got me there in one room.
What comes to mind to say in this circumstance is, you know, I can't believe that we're going to be there and get this opportunity, but that's not the case. I've always believed that you were going to get that opportunity. I've always believed that your dream was going to happen. It won't be the shock and surprise that we're doing it, because I dreamed that dream along with you. You know, I prayed the same prayers you were praying, and it's just going to be special.
My grandparents, they love the Grand Ole Opry, so I know they're watching up there, but this song is about Peg and Dewey Coomer, and it's called Jesus and Me.
Well, it was me and Grandpa on the front porch one Christmas Eve, telling stories about his daddy and the war, a little bit of everything. You should have seen his face light up when I asked him about Grandma. He said her daddy told us we were away.
But it's like at the end of the day, I just want to be a part of the history of country music in Nashville. And that legitimately is the Grand Ole Opry. 2 years ago, he said, let your prayer be, Lord, don't let my influence be wider than my character is deep. It's like when you learn to trust that prayer and really mean it, there's so much peace in all this, because it's all just like a blessing, you know? Oftentimes what I even prayed for, but it was perfect, and it is perfect. And like, so it's hard to just like slow down, look around and be like, I'm living exactly where I dreamed my whole life. I sat in math class, I sat in center field or dreamed in my head I would be this new artist in Nashville who had songs that people knew, and it's hard to cherish that a lot of times. But it's like the Grand Ole Opry is different. It like it forces you to.
Grand Ole Opry, thank you guys so much.
For the very first time on the Grand Ole Opry stage, ladies and gentlemen, Connor Smith. And for those listening, that is the sound of a standing ovation in the Opry House.